This video has been produced for consumers who have the Spektrum DX6i radio, with particular attention to those radios with date codes of 809E, 810E, 811E, and 812E. In this video, we will show you how to perform the self-evaluation process. If you discover an irregularity with your radio, please return it by completing the DX6i product inspection request form available for download from SpektrumRC.com. You may be wondering, how do you know if your DX6i needs to be checked? As a general rule of thumb, we are recommending that all consumers should check their radios. Radios with a date code of 809E, 810E, 811E, and 812E should be carefully checked. You can find the date code for your radio in one of two locations. The first location is on the back side of your battery door. The second location is under the batteries themselves. Please note that if your radio features a date code of 809EUS, 810EUS, 811EUS, or 812EUS, your product has already been inspected by Spektrum. In some instances, you may not have a date code label on your radio, or it may have come off. If your radio does not have a date code or your date code has come off, this test is still advisable. As always, we recommend users should always conduct pre-flight checklists and range testing prior to each use of your product according to the DX6i programming guide. Please consult your manual for detailed instructions on how to perform this check. There is a simple test we are going to demonstrate for you here showing how to determine if your particular DX6i needs to be serviced. If irregularities are found, please circle them and include the test document with your DX6i product inspection request available for download from SpektrumRC.com. In order to perform this test, you'll need to access your radio's monitor screen. To access this screen, you'll need to power the radio on. Once the radio powers up, depress the roller selector to access the setup list. From this screen, scroll down to menu item 9, labeled Setup List. Depress the roller selector again to enter this menu. Scroll down to the third item in this list, labeled Monitor. Once Monitor is highlighted, depress the roller selector once again to access the monitor screen. Within this screen, you will be able to view the stick travel on a graph. To perform the test, smoothly move the sticks in each axis, carefully watching the command position on the monitor. The monitor should show smooth movement tracking with the input. If the monitor jumps around, hesitates, or doesn't smoothly follow your stick movements, please send your system in for service. We have three examples here for you of different radios. In this first radio, you'll notice that even when the throttle stick is in the full down position, the throttle position in the monitor screen never drops below 1/2 on the graph. This is a radio that requires service. Next, on this radio, the aileron movements are choppy on the graph. If someone were to fly with this radio, they would notice an imprecise feeling behind the sticks. This radio should also be sent in for service. Finally, on this third radio, you will notice here the stick movements are smoothly replicated on the monitor display screen below. This is an example of a radio that is operating normally. If you did not find any irregularities, your DX6i does not need to be sent in for inspection. As always, please conduct pre-flight checks and range testing prior to each and every use of your product according to the DX6i programming guide and instruction manual. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to contact Spektrum Product Support.